sir, we have implemented several schemes to stop the corruption. And when the worker goes to the site, there will be two timestamp geotag pictures will be taken. And then we have Janman app where users can report all the irregularities. But whether it is West Bengal or any other state, they must take this responsibility, because implementation and monitoring is the responsibility of the state. And the funds that we were given is to help the unskilled people, which is a fallback mechanism. When they don't have any employment, this is their lifeline. And this money should not be used for corruption charges or subverting, like there are programs that they were supposed to do, but they are implementing contractor based, or if there are big projects that cannot be split, because when you have big projects with the material use, you will be giving proper tendering process. But when the big work is split into small blocks, you can nominate. So in West Bengal, some of these things are happening. So because of all these things, what we asked is, you know, look at all the people who have been committing these issues and tell us what actions have you taken on these. They did give some report and we are reviewing that report. And we will come back to that, sir. Thank you.
M. Srinivasal Reddy. Thank you very much, sir, for giving, you know, some time. I will not take much of your time, sir, but before I start my supplementary, sir, I would like to just request you, sir, the respect for the MPs, sir, senior MPs. Earlier, you know, I was there in the third row, so now I come to sixth row, sir. Please try to, you know, because only few fifth term, sixth term, seventh term MPs are here, sir, also. Please try to, you know.
Please, madam. Please, sir, I'll come to the question, sir.
Please. I'm coming to the question, sir.
Please, please, कोई भी माननीय सदस्य संसद की कार्य व्यवस्था पर कभी भी सदन में सवाल नहीं उठे. आपको कोई परेशानी है, कोई आपत्ति, तो आप चेंबर में मिले, संसदीय कार्यालय में लिखे. ये सभी माननीय सांसदों को मैं आग्रह करता हूं कि ये परंपरा परोपकारी और नियम प्रक्रिया भी रही है.
जो थैंक यू वेरी मच सर फॉर गिविंग सम टाइम सर रिगार्डिंग दिस नो आंसर्स गिवन बाय नो आवर ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर is very, very proper regarding only Andhra Pradesh. You know, some pending liabilities are there, sir, even though he is also from Andhra Pradesh, Honorable Minister. I would like to request him also when all those things will be cleared also, sir. Thank you.
Said, there are not that many pending liabilities for any given state. For the entire country, what I see is 700 crores of liability. For Andhra Pradesh, it's coming around 150 crores. And again, as I said earlier, this is a dynamic process. Every day the money will be going to respective state, depending on the state, whether it is 10 crores or 20 crores. So there is nothing that's pending, but whatever is pending will be cleared usually within 2 to 3 days. Thank you.
Question number 108 ko bhi club kiya jata hai. Question number 108, Sri K.C. Venugopal. Mani Mantri ji.
The answer is laid in the table of the house. Thank you.
Maniya Sadashya.
Thank you, Speaker, sir, for giving me an opportunity for intervening in this question number. I'm very happy, Speaker, sir, while replying the Honorable Minister, talk about the good heart of Honorable Prime Minister. But the country knows that the same Prime Minister told that this is a clear memorial of the UPA corruption, this Manrega, in that house. My question, sir, you are talking about the allocation. Scheme is initiated on 2006. Now 18 years are over. After 18 years, our entire budget outlay has been increased several times. Then you are telling every day we are increasing 5,000, 6,000. Here I have a statistics. It is shocking that, sir, in the last 4 years, names of 10.43 crore Manrega workers across India have been deleted, sir. 10.43 crore workers. Then in 21-22, 1.49 crore workers were deleted. which surged to 5.53 crore in 22-23, resulting in net 247% increase in deletion, sir. Not increase in deletion, sir. Sir, I have a specific question. In surge of deletion 22-23 coincided with the period when the Union Government has issued several circulars making Aadhaar-based payment system mandatory in Manrega. My question to the minister, whether the ministry has gone through this issue, whether you have found out that the Aadhaar-linked direction and circular has affected the deletion of the workers.
Thank you. The first question you said, we are not increasing the budget. I just want to quote during your government, in 2009 and 10, no, I'll come to you, you answered that we asked. 2009 and 10, the budget estimate was 39,000 crores. You released 33,000 crores, so 6,000 crores less. No, let me come back to you. So, and again in 2011 and 12, the budget estimate was 40,000 crores and you released 29,000 crores. And again, 2012 and 13, budget estimate was revised lower to 33,000 crores and you released 30,000 crores. I gave you 3 years of example where you could not even meet your own budget estimates. And I have given, during last 5 years, every year we increased 20,000 crores. So that's number one. And number two, Aadhaar seeding, 99% of all job card holders have Aadhaar seeding. And there are no issues. And job Aadhaar seeding has nothing but increasing the transparency. This is a means to deliver the amount directly into the bank. It has no intervention whatsoever and it is not an obstacle. And the job deletions, again, as I said, are based on five factors. If there is a fake card, duplicate card, if the person moves from one panchayat to another panchayat, or if the person expired, if the person doesn't want to work anymore, or if that area becomes urbanized from rural area. These are the criteria for the job deletion. And again, this is the responsibility of the state. The central government do not have any role whatsoever in job deletion.
Again, you are misleading the house. I am sorry to say that. Because my question is that, comparing to the budget, total budget outlay, how much you are providing for Manrega? That the percentage of this thing that what we are asking. Now, sir, now he is talking about the honorable minister is talking about the deletion. This is completely for five parameters, sir. This five parameter during. Only through these five parameters, 10.43 crore people is going to be deleted. We cannot understand that.
Okay.
10.43 crore labors are deleted. You are telling about this parameter, double entry, this thing. That may, you are indirectly insulting the laborers through this. I think that I am doing Disha meeting every 3 months. I know the factors from the ground. This is not suit for with your arguments. The ground reality is not suit with your argument. So my question also, in your reply itself you told an amount of 16,300 crore was pending liability for wage, material and admission for component. You know, app payment is not happening. The Manrega workers are very poor. You are giving them after 1 year, after 8 months, you are giving salary, I am agreeing that. But giving salary in a delayed way.
Maniye Mantri ji.
Basically, you are defeating the purpose of the...
No, we are not defeating. I am happy to answer one by one. 57% of rural development budget is being allocated to Manrega. That's number one. And you said second, the job card deletion and update. If you take consistently average job deletion, every year, there is 60 lakh new job cards are being issued. On an average, around 30 lakh job cards are being deleted due to various reasons. And the total number of job cards are around 13 to 14 crores, and this is a static number. And the total number of active job cards are around 9.2 crores. And if you want the exact number, I'm happy to give you. New job cards issued in 22-23, 65 lakhs, 23-24, 50 lakhs. So, the total number of active job cards are In 21, 9.58 crores. In 22, went down 10 lakhs, 9.49. Again in 23, it went up 20 lakhs. So 9.79 crore active job cards. So where is the number that you are talking that the number 2 crore job cards are being deleted? These are the actual facts, sir.
Okay.